Good job.
Bit of a problem with the slideshow today, but now we're all good. So I see a lot of familiar faces in this crowd. So thank you all for continuously coming back to our programs. It's really nice to see all of you here. As some of you are aware, we've been doing this for almost 8-9 months now, and. Today, on the last day of this year that we'll probably always remember, we're very happy to bring you a very inspiring group of young people that have been working in Sindhu Bhatu primarily, I think, but also, sorry? Kumari Show. They've been working in Kumari Show, one of the areas affected by the earthquake, where they are building schools and shelters. They have the school program and the shelter program, and this is a group of architects and engineers and IT students, and like a very diverse group, but everyone with a like-mindedness, and the primary aim is to look into locally available methods and use local technology, not necessarily technologies, but definitely locally inspired technology to support the rebuilding. So basically, I would like to invite the entire team to please come forward. I'll just take their names. So please, let's all welcome them. I am Paramacharya, not here, okay. And Emil Shrestha. Yes, that's Emil. And Rajani Swal, is she here? Rajani, hi. Rajani Rasana. Rasana Shrestha. Sashindra Dongo. Simal Shrestha, Susan Shrestha, Sudhil Shrestha, Chivan Taman, and Ryan Horan. This is from the ground up. Please welcome them with a round of applause. Thank you for coming here. And now I give the mic to Chivan, and I ask every one of you to please be seated with us. I give the mic to Chivan to start with their discussion, and yeah.
Thank you for having me. A lovely presentation. Well, I need to get used to this. Okay. Anyway, thank you guys for coming, for showing up, for not leaving. Not up to a very good start. We're actually pretty late, so we're going to try and finish the presentation in the limited time we already have. As what Didi mentioned, we're from the ground up. We're actually a pretty young collective. We formed quite recently, actually, after the earthquake. Anyway, if you're ready, I'd like to start the presentation. Slide. Next. So, I would definitely like to acknowledge the earthquake that happened almost a year ago. The Godha earthquake, was a very devastating natural disaster that took the lives of thousands of people and left many homeless.
So in the wake of the disruption, like everyone was busy with the relief operation and the rescue operation and the damage management. So and at the same time, one of our classmates just came to us, approached us, called us, and asked us to be there for the damage management. So one was like down in, say, okay. Then the other members, like our friends, came in, down in for the whole damage management team.
This isn't going to be a serious presentation, so.
So as we were involved in the damage management, we kind of feel us like we should be doing something more significant. So after all, like we were all fresh architects, fresh engineers, so we thought of doing something much more valuable and much more significant. So the next day, we went for the brainstorming and came up with the idea of the second city.
Yeah, I mean, that's just a fancy name for that we used to call ourselves. So basically, we were all fresh graduates, architects, and although distributing foods and medicine was pretty important at the time, we just felt that it was more significant to work towards rebuilding, to work towards providing shelter to those people who didn't already have one.
So the first site where we went was Dharmastali. So we went to Dharmastali first, did a little small case study, then an observation, and then we came back to Kathmandu. And we kind of collected the materials, resources, response, development,
material. Pretty high tech.
So this was what we all started with. So the next day, when we went back to Dharmastali to start our project, to start the construction, but we decided to start with a simple temporary shelter for teaching for a camp of 56 families. So we spent the whole day doing all this, and at the end of the day, this was what we all had. So still we had GISs and other stuff to be within there. But like at the end of the day, like, we were like, oh, just let it be, we'll come tomorrow and continue the whole work again.
So we were actually pretty, this was pretty over our heads, I mean. We were just like, oh, we're just going to go there and build this blah blah blah. But it didn't work out that way.
And the next day we went back to Dharmastali, but the family, the tent for whom we built this center, they were having a party, a porridge party. So we went there to finish the structure, but instead like, they offered us the pudding, they offered us the heat, and like sent us back. So at the time we kind of felt that like we should be something much more significant and do, and be much more involved in some other places.
Yeah, I mean, we definitely needed to be somewhere that people actually did need our help. So the next place that we went to was Panirgaon. It's in a place called Dabin. I don't know if you almost hear
Panirgaon. So in Panirgaon too, like we went there, we did small like case studies, observation, we came up with simple data reports. And on the basis of our observation and our stuff, like we came up with a design idea of semi-permanent shelter, which can be easily used using salvage materials that can be obtained from the areas over there. So the whole idea behind the construction of the semi-shelter structure was like to provide an immediate temporary shelter for the victim. But as well as in near future, we intended the whole structure to be used for other purposes like the
sheds. So yeah, at this point it was basically just as friends. We didn't have much experience on this. But we were pretty sure we were onto something, that this would lead to somewhere, something good.
So after Panirgaon, we kind of like get back to ideas and starting to think that we should be doing. If we were to do, if we were to continue this, we need proper homework, we need proper assessment studies. So we went to monitor, did some observations or case studies, and came up with this report of around like we did general observation of around 46 degree offset as per the NEH orientation program that was conducted at the time.
For those of you who are not aware of NEA, that's Nepal Engineering Association. And we did a visual assessment based on the orientation that it gave us. So besides all of this information, we came to a sad conclusion that most of the people there weren't they aren't going to be able to rebuild their homes for at least 5 to 6 years. So we definitely got motivated to do something about it. Yeah.
So as per our case study and general observation over there, we came up with few design ideas that could be implemented in the village. So the first idea was using salvage materials from the ruins in the same village. And the other idea was to use the art back buildings. Similarly, the other one was
Waterland.
So with this idea, we went back to the village, talked to the stakeholders, to the locals over there, and decided to build a model house on the basis of the first idea using the salvage materials from the ruins. So for that again, we came back to Kathmandu, like brainstorm, gathered all resources, funding, volunteers, and we went back to the village. So the first thing what we did was like we just set up an open camp over there. And then we started the thing from the next day. So the whole thing went on and went on and went on like for 3-4 weeks, I think.
3-4 weeks.
So and at the end of the week, like all we had was the soft structure, the foundation. Pakistan, pretty much built up at the state challenge ruins and the post. And like, after a few weeks of work, like, it was...
Yeah, I mean, we were really short on funds. The money we had collected was actually from out of our own pockets, from our friends of friends. So we were actually facing pretty dire conditions, I mean, money-wise.
Yeah, likewise, the life was going back to normal, so all the volunteers that we had, they started resuming to their normal lives, and also the amounts were not there, so we decided to retreat at the time. So we decided to halt the whole project for some time period. So we had to leave the whole construction site in this way. Just to be a East Coast garden, like vegetable garden at the time.
Can you go back to the next one? Yeah, I mean, there were a lot of organizations actually working around the valley. So we decided to use social media to like get in touch with these people, improve our networking. Right, so we created a Facebook page where we posted all the work we had done earlier. And I think this is how we actually met Nicholas Gabriel. Unfortunately, he's not here with us, but he's definitely one of the important members from the ground up.